Salam.
Salam to you, worthy friends. Welcome to the fabled city of Agrabah.
We come from a land, from a far away place, where the caravan camels roam. It's flat and immense, and the heat is intense. But hey, it's home.
Once, in a mysterious city of Agrabah, lived a poor boy named Aladdin. He took over his father's shop after he passed away.
One day, while Aladdin was at the shop, a stranger approached him.
"Hello, Aladdin. I am your father's friend. I heard about his demise. I was not in the city at that time."
"I have never heard about you."
"Oh, Aladdin, I have come to take you to a secret, magnificent place which may hold the key to end all your sorrows."
"A secret place?"
"A place which holds a hidden treasure, riches beyond reckoning."
"A treasure? Riches? You mean like dominoes? Okay, let's go."
Zafar and Aladdin get on camel's back and travel for days across the desert and reach a narrow valley.
"Here we are."
"Finally, I will gather some sticks and light a fire. Order me a thin crust."
The man threw some powder in the fire and started to chant some magical words.
Beneath the ground,
a stone came up with a ring on it.
"Oh, oh, Uncle, I'm getting scared."
"Fear nothing and do as I say. Beneath this stone lies the treasure. But first, take the ring."
Aladdin took the ring and the stone moved away, revealing a staircase.
"Go down and keep walking till you get to a place. There stands a lighted lamp. Bring it to me. The ring will protect you."
Okay, Uncle."
Aladdin went down carefully massive cave full of treasure.
Aladdin collected many valuable items and finally reached the lamp. He picked up the lamp and carried it to the staircase along with his collected treasure.
Come on, hand the lamp to me.
Uncle, my hands are full. Help me.
You silly boy. Give me the lamp or stay here forever. I'll shut the entrance of this cave.
The man muttered some words and Aladdin got locked inside the cave.
Uncle, let me come out.
I shouldn't have believed that man.
Aladdin cried and cried, waiting for someone to rescue him.
Somebody! Get me out of here! Please help me!
Saying his wish, Aladdin touched his ring.
And to his surprise,
without internet. You are my master. What is your wish?
My wish?
Yes, I am genie. Tell me your wish. Is it to understand the concept of direct and indirect speech? Or to know how to draw all the different angles in geometry?
Tempting. My wish is,
I desire that my mother's trial be rewarded. Turn my house into a palace and give my mother all the comforts of an affluent life.
Wow! How beautiful my palace looks! So big! And the ceilings, they're so high! It looks like a dream!
There was an announcement that Sultan is looking for a suitable groom for his daughter, the princess, and many princesses from other kingdoms will be coming to Agraba.
Princess Jasmine. I'm sorry. Can't you see? Where are you going? Sorry.
First time in the marketplace, right?
What makes you think it's my first time?
solid gold earrings, fancy clothes, and not a speck of dust on your shoes.
I guess it's a kind of obvious.
Take the carpet, show the princes around.
Lucky for you, I know this place like I know the songs of Badshah. I'll show you around a different Agrabah.
Aladdin spent few hours together and realized they like each other. Jasmine suddenly realizes that she has been gone too long and leaves to rush to the palace.
Ginny, I know what my wish is. I wish to impress the Sultan and marry the princess.
Googly Woogly Wash, your wish is my command.
Ginny gives Aladdin a royal makeover and they leave to go to the palace, bringing along with them gems Aladdin got from the cave.
So many suitors, no one apt for my darling daughter.
Aladdin and Genie's presence is announced.
Salam, Sultan, King of Kings. May I present the most handsome, the richest, the wisest, Aladdin, here to woo Princess Jasmine.
Regards, Sultan. I come bearing gifts from my recent exploits. I wish to marry Princess Jasmine.
This is the same boy. He's using my lamb to gain Princess Jasmine's hand in marriage.
What the f-
Salam to you, Aladdin. But first, to impress me, you must answer few questions.
Oh, okay.
Please ask.
Who invented the telephone?
Alexander Graham Bell.
Ooh, correct.
How many parts is the Constitution of India divided into?
Oh, I should have paid more attention in the history and civics classes. 25 parts.
Voila!
Oof! Next question. What is our nervous system made up of?
My nervous system is made of magic and food. Oops, sorry.
I know it. Nerves, brains in most cases, and the spinal cord.
Correct.
Woohoo!
Yay!
Oh no!
Last but not the least, what is 1000 into 38.7 into 0 plus 8?
Ooh, mathematics question. 0? No, 8.
Correct, my boy. You have impressed me. You have my permission to marry Jasmine.
Yay, hooray!
Oh, Aladdin.
All of the court rejoices.
No! I am supposed to marry Jasmine. She is mine.
What?
Yes. I took this boy to the cave. I wanted the lamb. Couldn't enter the cave because only a honest and noble person could.
Oh, that is why you tricked me and left me there to die.
You have my lamb and you are using it to win Jasmine? You? The lamb belongs to me. Your riches and all this affluence is fake. You, Aladdin, must die.
What? What is the meaning of this?
Genie! Help!
Google!
Oogly Boogly Woosh!
Your wish is my command!
Genie helps Aladdin and Jasmine and takes away the staff from Zafar and captures him.
You treacherous monster! You, Zafar, tried to harm my daughter! You, Ali Zafar, are sentenced to be locked away in the dungeons without mobile or any fast food.
No! No!
Zafar is taken away.
You are knowledgeable, but you are poor. I'm sorry.
But Sultan, please consider my friend. He's a good boy.
No.
Oh, Father, I love Aladdin. I'm not marrying him for his riches and diamonds, but for his nature and Amazon Prime password. He even has a Zomato membership.
Dear daughter, I want you to be happy. Okay, you can marry Aladdin.
Thank you, Sultan.
Jasmine and Aladdin were married and they lived happily. Aladdin and Genie went on to have many other adventures, often accompanied by us. Isn't it, Chirag?
Yes. So folks, this is all for now.
We will soon return with another story from the Arabian Nights.
Arabian Nights, like Arabian days. More often than not, are hotter than hot in a lot of good ways. Arabian Nights, like Arabian dreams. This mystical land of magic and sand is more than it seems. Arabian Nights, like Arabian days. More often than not, are hotter than hot in a lot of good ways. Arabian Nights, like Arabian dreams. This mystical land of magic and sand is more than it seems.